Can eye drops worsen dry eyes? Artificial tears are a first-line treatment for dry eye disease. But then why do some people report that their eyes feel worse after using eye drops? In this video, we're going to explain why this can sometimes happen, as well as share some helpful tips so that this doesn't happen to you in your dry eyes treatment. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. So recently I had a patient tell me that his eyes were feeling worse after using eye drops. He reported that he had dry eye for several years and got into the habit of just buying eye drops over the counter and had been using them about 4 to 6 times a day. But recently he reported that his eyes started to burn after putting his eye drops in, and he felt his eyes were becoming more and more red over time. First off, let me know in the comment section right now if this has ever happened to you where your eyes felt worse or they burn or stung when you put your eye drops in. I would bet it's a lot more common than you'd think. In this particular patient's case, I immediately asked him what brand of eye drops he was using, and again, he was using about 4 to 6 times a day, and he reported using either Visine or a brand called Clear Eyes. And immediately I was like, I think I know what's going on here. Now, if you've seen any of our other videos on eye drops, you know that not all eye drops are made the same. And eye drops that are labeled get the red out often contain ingredients which can irritate the eyes and make dry eye worse. These type of drops usually have an ingredient called tetrahydrazoline in it. This helps constrict the blood vessels on the surface of the eye, making them look more white. However, it also tends to wear off and not become as effective over time, really becoming less and less effective the more you use it. And it also happens to have a rebound effect. So eventually when it starts to wear off, your eyes rebound and the redness gets worse, which then you often end up using it again to make your eyes look more white, and then it rebounds and makes your eyes look more red, so then you use it again, and the cycle just goes on and on. Most of the time though, when people feel burning or irritation right after they put eye drops in, it's actually because of the preservatives that are in those eye drops. Now, many of the newer eye drops on the market, they do have preservatives, but they have what is called a soft preservative, which means that when it leaves the bottle, it denatures and doesn't cause any damage to the ocular surface, or is to at least believed to not be as bad. But many generics and older brands of eye drops, including prescription medications, often have a preservative in it called benzalkonium chloride, also known as BAK. It is a great preservative and does do its job at preventing the bottle from getting contaminated, but it does cause damage to the ocular surface, and some people are even allergic to it. And even in some cases, we see the ocular surface become almost completely eroded because of this, which we call medicamentosa. And for any of my young budding eye doctors out there, that means that when you're staining with fluorescein and you're looking under the slit lamp, you may see a very diffuse SPK across the entire cornea, as well as on the conjunctiva. SPK is short for superficial punctate keratitis, which kind of looks like these tiny little divot marks all over the entire eye. It's basically a diffuse sign of tissue damage. Now, to help prevent this issue from happening to you, number one, avoid using eye drops that are labeled get the red out. There is a newer eye drop called Lumify, which doesn't have the same rebound effect as the many others. However, it still has preservatives in it, and so I only recommend it for occasional use, such as like special occasions or if you're going to take photographs with family, things like that. Number two is to try to use preservative-free eye drops if you can. Otherwise, make sure to talk with your local eye doctor about what type of dry eye you may have and what eye drop they would recommend for you in your case. Again, there are many different eye drops on the market, and unfortunately, not all of them are preservative-free. Now, if preservative-free eye drops are not an option for you, or you happen to take prescription eye drop medications, then consider looking into the NanoDropper eyedropper attachment, which is the sponsor for today's video. But I think it's pretty ingenious that they were able to find a way that they can make eye drops smaller by about 70%, which makes your eye drops not only last longer, but it reduces the waste of the medication and reduces the amount of eye drop that's getting to the surface of the eye, including all of the preservatives. And with less preservatives, you can hopefully reduce any irritation or potential ocular surface damage. We actually use the NanoDropper on almost all of the bottles of eye drops here in our eye clinic. If you do want to learn more about the NanoDropper, I'll put additional information and links in the description below if you want to check it out. Hey, otherwise, I appreciate you watching the video. If you did learn something new and you like learning this information, hit that like button for us and subscribe to the channel if you are new. If you happen to struggle with things like dry eye and want to learn more about different eye drops or need some tips on how to put them in, if you're having, you know, struggle hitting your eyes, I got a whole bunch of videos coming up for you. Check those out. Otherwise, keep an eye on it and we'll see you in the next one.